Okay, good morning everyone. Today I'll start with your new chapter, Electrochemistry. This one is your third chapter. Two chapters already done, first, second. This one is your third chapter, again very important chapter. Okay, in this chapter we'll study about Ohm's law. Okay, that one is resistance, conductivity, conductance. Okay, electrochemical cell, electrolytic cell, different types of cell, fuel cell, okay, then Nernst equation. So many things you will study in this chapter, important, and numericals are important for your exam point of view as well as for your that one competitive point of view also. Okay, now otherwise now in this chapter, okay, first of all question arises, what is electrochemistry? Okay, now simple, in case of electrochemistry, actually it's a branch of chemistry which deals with the study of conversion of chemical energy into electrical energy, or you can say electrical energy into chemical energy, and their mutual relationship, that one is known as electrochemistry. I think we have learned about electrochemical cell. Generally it's a device which convert chemical energy into electrical energy. Okay, so simple, in electrochemistry we will study about the conversion of chemical energies into electrical, or you can say it's a vice versa, that one is regarding to electrochemistry. Now before I'll start with this chapter, okay, two three important things that you should know, because that one is very important in this chapter. Okay, first term is electrolytes. Okay, either you can say electrolytes or either you can say electrolytic conductors. Okay, so what are electrolytes? Okay, actually electrolytes are those substances which allow, yeah, those substances which allow the electricity to pass through them in their molten state or in the form of their aqueous solution. Okay, and undergo chemical decomposition. Means in simple terms that electrolytes, I think you know that in case of electrolyte the force of attraction is strong, so in solid state generally it is poor conductor of electricity, but in molten and aqueous state electrolytes allow to pass electricity through them, and it when it dissolved in water then it dissociate into ions also, positive and negative ions. You can take any example, for example that it's a NaCl. I think you know when it dissociate it gives Na positive, Cl negative. Even acid, that one is HCl, then it gives H positive and Cl negative, all in obviously aqueous solution, so they dissociate into ions, so that one is known as electrolyte, and in that condition only they are allowed to pass electricity through them. Okay, now in case of electrolyte we have two types of electrolyte, one is a strong electrolyte, okay, another one is weak electrolyte. Okay, in case of strong electrolyte, okay, strong electrolyte, those who completely dissociate into ions, completely ionize or completely dissociate into ions, for example NaCl, KCl, NaOH, KOH, HCl, H2SO4, they are strong electrolytes. Okay, another one we have weak electrolyte. Okay, weak electrolyte, those who partially dissociate into ions. Okay, partially, for example, just see in case of partially dissociation, that one is CH3COOH. You know, it's a weak acid. It dissociate like this, CH3COO negative plus H3O positive in aqueous solution, or you can say it's a H positive, it's a hydronium ion. So just see, this one is ion as well as molecular part is also present. Okay, either you write like this equation like this, okay, or otherwise it's a H positive. So just see, it's ionic as well as molecular form, that's why it's a weak electrolyte, because partially dissociate into ions. Okay, this one is general thing. Now what are non-electrolytes? Opposite of electrolyte, non-electrolyte, those substances which do not conduct electricity neither in molten state, not in solid state, not in aqueous state. Okay, generally they are, okay, in this one ions are not present when they dissociate into ions. For example, it's a glucose, sugar, urea. Generally, they are non-electrolytes. Okay, now in this one, we'll study two important things. One is metallic and another one is electrolytic conductor, or either you can say electrolytic conductance. Okay, all of you know about metals. Okay, those substances, those who are good conductor of electricity, heat, they have metallic luxure, okay, malleable, ductile, but regarding to conductance, they allow to pass electricity through them without undergoing any chemical decomposition. Okay, that one is regarding to metallic conductance. Electrolytes already explained to you. Okay, now we will study metallic conduction and electrolytic conduction in the form of difference. Okay, so simple, that is one simple question, that is difference between metallic and electrolytic conduction. Again, very important for your exam point of view. Okay, now this one is, so if you know both the thing, metallic and electrolytic conduction, then difference is easy. First of all, you know, in case of metals, generally there is a movement of electron. So who is responsible for conducting electricity? That one is electron. But in case of electrolyte, I think you know that electrolyte dissociate into ions, and in case of electrolyte, ions are responsible for conducting electricity. Now in case of metal, as I told you, okay, metal allow to pass electricity through them without undergoing any chemical decomposition. Okay, so in this one, it involves no chemical change. But in case of electrolytic conduction, it involves chemical decomposition. Okay, due to chemical reaction, just like KCl, it gives K positive, Cl negative, NaOH, it gives Na positive, O, H negative. Okay, now simple, metallic conduction, then it does not involve any transfer of matter. Okay, in this one there is no transfer of matter, but it involves transfer of matter in the forms of ion. Okay, now in case of simple thing, just see, in case of metallic conduction there is no change in that one is chemical change. Okay, have you seen wire? Either it's an aluminium wire, either it's a copper wire, those who are responsible for conducting electricity. Okay, when electricity passes through these wires, okay, it's never happened ki jo usme uska kuch chemical decomposition ho jaye. Okay, that one, it means that copper wire remain same, aluminium wire remain same, so no chemical decomposition in it. Okay, now metallic conduction, that it decreases with increase in temperature. Metallic conduction, it decreases with increase in temperature. Electrolytic conduction, it increases with a rise in temperature. Okay, this one is regarding to metallic and electrolytic conduction. Okay, thank you.